wrong surface operations are a serious and continuing issue at airports throughout the national airspace system. The majority of these incidents involve general aviation aircraft and pilots. The types of incidents fall into several main categories. This video is focused on one such category: approaching or landing at the wrong airport. Even with today's highly accurate and readily available technology, pilots are still misidentifying their airport of intended landing, often going so far as making an approach to or actually landing at an airport other than their planned destination. The problem occurs with pilots operating under both visual and instrument flight rules. In some cases, the cause of the confusion is apparent. Large metropolitan areas can have several airports, all in close proximity. These airports can have similar, if not identical, runway configurations, even if they are drastically different in size. Airports that are located along the instrument final approach course have been mistaken for the airport that the approach is being conducted to, even if they are located several miles away from the correct runway. Complex airspace, frequency congestion, distractions, and lack of familiarity with the area can lead a pilot to lose situational awareness and mistakenly identify the wrong airport. It can happen to you. The consequences of this mistake can vary. One can imagine the embarrassment of pulling up to the fuel pumps or FBO only to discover that you're at the wrong airport. However, some consequences can be very serious. Pilots may be surprised by a shorter-than-expected runway. Or worse, they could conflict or possibly collide with aircraft operating at the airport, in the pattern, or on the ground. How can pilots avoid this costly and potentially catastrophic error? First, during pre-flight planning, either IFR or VFR, check the sectional chart for airports in close proximity. Pay close attention to runway configurations, as they may be similar in appearance. Note geographical features such as the airport's relationship to the city or town and expected visual perspective, with nearby rivers, highways, and charted reporting points. Second, check airport diagrams. Be familiar with your destination airport's layout and relationship to other ground features like terminals, hangars, and other runways and taxiways, and their orientation to your final approach course. Understand the available lighting such as visual glide slope indicators, approach light systems, and runway lighting. Third, use the most precise navigational aids available. Do use GPS, localizers, and VOR radials to positively identify your airport. Do not make assumptions based purely on what you see outside. Rather, use all your available tools to identify the correct airport. Maintain extra vigilance when identifying your destination airport at night and when landing at an airport with others in close proximity. Confirm that the geographical features you've identified in your pre-flight planning match your visual picture as you approach your intended airport. And finally, do not report the airport in sight or decide that you're seeing the correct airport until you are 100% sure that it is your airport. If you're talking to ATC and you're unsure, ask. An extra transmission is well worth avoiding the embarrassment or accident that could occur. These are just a few tips that can help pilots avoid making this costly and dangerous mistake. For more information about this and other runway safety topics, visit these resources. Avoiding mistakes like approaching or landing at the wrong airport makes flying more efficient, fun, and above all, safe. It's always better to know before you go.